How do you plan to maintain IXICO's differentiation as other neuroimaging and AI-driven firms enter the space? What's your unique selling point as you see it?
So the unique selling point of IXICO is very much in that neurodegenerative space and in that R&D space. So we are actually the only company that really focuses on the brain. Our competitors are mainly looking at the entire body, if you wish. So they're very deep into oncology, for example. And in addition, we're very much also in that R&D space, so Alzheimer's, Parkinson's, and helping pharma, biotech with the development of novel drugs. And we do believe that that's a growing space. We see that as well. We've equipped our platform to go there. And so that is where we see growth in the near future.
I mean, you mentioned your dominance in Huntington's and now accelerating your existing presence in Alzheimer's and Parkinson's. What makes IXICO's platform well suited to these conditions?
It does take time to develop a platform and get algorithms on those platforms or on that platform that really stand the test of regulated biomarker research. And so that is something that IXICO has been doing for over 15 years. We've equipped our platform with especially biomarkers, imaging biomarkers in the neurodegenerative space. And that is work that cannot easily be replicated. So we have proof of concepts in all these different disease areas. And so for us, it becomes very easy to actually unlock some of those and start to commercialize biomarkers as we see the field evolving into certain areas.
Can you explain how expanding into post-market surveillance and go-to-market support changes the size or quality of your addressable market?
So post-marketing surveillance is a little bit of a big term to say when drugs actually make it to market. Obviously, surveillance is needed, whether that's for safety or for efficacy. And as we now see, of course, that especially in Alzheimer's, for example, some of these therapies do make it to market. And luckily, we do start to see some successes in clinical research. The idea is that because we've been working with these companies on biomarkers, that we follow them on the market. And why? Because regulators will want to have safety measurement, but also reimbursement authorities, for example, will want to have biomarkers to look at which populations are we truly going to access. So it is that segment which we see as an expansion, definitely now that we see therapies coming to market as well.